We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Better than beautiful. See, you're the reason men fall in love. You're the best part of waking up. Better than Folgers in my cup. The only way to stop my day. People trying to live like queens and kings. Thinking money changes everything. But you so different. The way you living is paving a new way. Cause there's no doubting, I'm all about it. No more searching, love I found it. Ended up with my heart and soul. About time that you know. If you just believe.
Welcome, coming to you live from the studios of LA Talk Live in sunny Los Angeles, California. This is Alayna's Beauty Talk and More, and I'm your host, Alayna. We're here to talk about beauty and more and all its expressions every Wednesday at noon Pacific time. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. This is Alayna's Beauty Talk and More on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
Beauty Magnets, Cleopatra's Beauty Ritual. Beauty Magnets are a modern-day spin on an ancient beauty secret. Beauty Magnets are a unique system of relaxation, revitalization, and renewal. Face and spirit reach a new level of balanced beauty, making you look and feel radiant. Tiny charged magnets increase circulation, promoting the look and feel of a natural lift. Face and spirit reach a new level of balanced beauty. De-stress your face with magnet therapy. Beauty Magnets of Beverly Hills, Hollywood. Available at www.beautymagnets.com. That's www.beautymagnets.com. Beauty Magnets, Cleopatra's Beauty Ritual, and proud sponsors of Alayna's Beauty Talk.
Hi, this is Susie Pruden, and yes, you've seen me on Oprah, Good Morning America, and The Today Show, and I'm inviting you to join me every Monday from 3 to 4 for my new show, Mastermind Live. Join us as we introduce you to the new thought leaders of the world who will inspire you, support you, and guide you to your next level. So don't forget to tune into Mastermind Live exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Welcome back to Alayna's Beauty Talk and More. We have such a great show. All of January, I'm trying to bring you shows that inspire you, get you up, get moving, bring you new makeup and hair tips. But today, I want to get you up and moving. You know, not everybody likes going to a gym like me. Not everybody likes jogging. I mean, so there's lots of different things you can do to stay fit, stay happy, stay healthy. Yeah. And I'm a big fan of dance. You know, I grew up in ballet and dancing. So as you know, you've probably, she's been a regular on my show.
I feel like this is a home away from home.
It is, because you teach actually in this area. Yes. But I thought it would be a great idea to bring the tango back into the show, because if you start early in the year, by 6 months, you'll be really, you know, pretty good at it, you know, if you take it seriously.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
So it's just a new idea. Maybe it'll get you to take a class, just something to inspire you. Those of you who are just kind of sitting at work, you know, maybe it'll go in one ear and you'll actually listen to us and listen
I
how
sure
great
so.
It is. So
sure
sitting
so.
Next to me, I'd like to welcome to the show, Alayna.
Thank you
After
so
all
much.
This time, I think I did I pronounce it right?
That was perfect, actually.
Oh my God, it only took me 2 years. That's not bad.
Oh, well, that's what you get and, for Russian names, okay.
Yeah, but I'm Russian too.
And well, and yes, exactly. That's right. We share that in common.
Yeah,
that's
I'm Russian.
But
we have the
cheekbones. But have you ever been there?
No,
not yet.
Someday.
Okay.
Someday.
Well, thank you for having me on the show.
Oh, I love having you. I mean, I love talking about tango, talking about dance, just talking about things that are different. Even if you love going to the gym or you love Pilates, it's always good to use different muscles and use your brain in another way.
That's a really good point, actually. Tango, Argentine
okay.
tango specifically.
You
has
gotta
been,
talk louder.
I will.
When
oh, okay, okay, okay.
Get into I the think, mic. I don't want people to miss a word you have to say.
Oh no, neither do I.
I figured that.
Thank you. You just mentioned something that is actually a very big part of tango.
You got a loud voice.
Okay, oh, yeah, okay. Can you hear
okay,
me? Okay, good, good, good.
Okay.
The Argentine tango is unique because of how the dance is, and I'll get into it a little bit later, is that it actually stimulates your brain in a way that there's a lot of research proving that it slows down and or improves Alzheimer's and as well as other aging-related diseases like that, because it's just also the way you use the brain. It's not only the movement itself, but I'm collecting a lot of articles on that topic, and it's becoming actually one of the therapies, in fact, offered. Tango therapy is offered in some hospitals and stuff like that.
Wow. Yeah. I didn't really even realize that, but I know because, I mean, they say right foot, right arm, left arm, tip, pivot. I mean, you have to really get your brain ready to do that. And you know, it's different.
Well, it's a very intricate dance. It's a unique dance, truly different from any other dance that's out there. And I love dancing, period. I am a dance junkie. You turn on the music and I will be moving, doing whatever I know how to do to any music. So I'm not just a purist as far as, you know, tango is the only way to go. I dance salsa for 17 years and mambo. And so I'm a big advocate for social dance. I have never done ballroom, per se. I am not a ballet, you know, trained or formally trained. I'm actually formally trained musicians. Maybe that's why music moves me and I love to dance. But dance in general is one of the most fun, just in general, like expensive kind of exercises, because if you go to the gym and it's a physical exercise, and yes, you build up stamina and it's also commitment and all these different things that you work on. When you dance, you forget you're working out. You're having so much fun, you don't even care what's happening. But whatever's happening to your body is incredibly positive. So you're getting a lot of benefits without feeling like, oh my God, I gotta go to the gym again.
Yeah.
That's the fun part about it.
It is, because it's very social.
Yeah. It's also very social. There's huge
It's very social.
Yeah. And, you know, I've been dancing. I've mentioned this many, many times. I've been dancing for many years, and I personally discovered dance at the time where I just simply didn't even really, didn't know what to do with myself. I mean, my life has changed. It was very dark and very hard. It was after divorce and loss of my mom, and I had a lot of empty space and time, and I, you know, people go through a lot of things, even over the holidays. They go through a lot of kind of hard time, especially when they're alone and they don't have family or they're sick or whatever is going on. My personal experience is that what you do instead of sitting there and feeling sorry for yourself is you go creative. You think, what can I do while I'm feeling this way that I can jump in that will change my life and make me forget, you know, for a moment, or take me away from the hard part about, you know, what I'm feeling like, oh, I wish I had a family. I wish I had kids, whatever that is.
But tango becomes your family.
That's it. Exactly. It becomes so much more than just learning how to move around. It's one of the most powerful, just personal transformational things you can do. Because when I jumped into the dance class, which was a cheap community based class, one of those recreation department kind of things, I could not believe, like, I woke up, I came back to life. I started feeling like a woman again. I mean, after 13 years of unhappy marriage and kind of feeling disconnected from my femininity and just, you know, I didn't know whether I'm attractive, whether I'm not. I mean, you know, there's a lot of things that people go through. And then you get up there and you start dancing and moving, and the response of people and the friend, you know, just friendships and this interaction changes your life. So when you're considering, should I take that class? I have two left feet. I have, you know, I'm too old, too fat, blah, 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 blah. Whatever that is that you are talking yourself out of doing things, you need to stop. You need to stop, get off the couch, and say, you know, it's the beginning of the year. I have a bucket list. Let's cross those things off. And if dance is one of them, this is a great time to do it.
And dance is available everywhere.
Everywhere. It's so popular right now.
It's very popular. Prices are really good now. So, you know, you can start like you did it at, you know.
Recreation department. Every city has a recreation.
Exactly. Anywhere you want to go. You can go to Third Street Dance. I kept saying we have to match.
That's how we met, right?
That's how we met. Yeah, because that's near me. I've always known what a great studio it was.
That's right.
And I just called there saying I want to do a show on dance.
And I have been teaching there for 9 years. It's one of my most favorite places in LA because it's a place that's one of the schools where I went to learn. And I loved it so much. And I had some time on my hands at that time. And I started assisting because I loved helping people. It was just part of, you know, I have that kind of gift of being able to be patient with beginners and help, you know, guys are very, very insecure about dance. So I'm very good at that. And I started assisting, and then I was hired as an instructor. And I've been there for 10 years teaching Argentine tango.
Yay.
Well, thank you.
But you have to go to a class that's in your area. You can't drive an hour to take a class unless you really get good at it and that's a teacher you want to take from. But at the beginning,
just make it easy.
Make it easy.
Exactly. Don't look for obstacles.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Yes. Just make it easy until you get to a level where you feel like, oh, I want to take from this guy. I'll make the trip or take a class from this person.
Well, it becomes addicting. And this is a warning.
Yeah, it's everybody that I know that is into this, it is addicting. But it's a good addiction.
Well, you know, let's put it this way. In all honesty, any addiction can go out of balance.
Right.
Because I know people who dance 7 times a week. Okay. When do they have time to date or do anything else? But it's at least from, if you're going to literally, you know, think about addictions that are out there. Yeah, definitely beats drinking, I think, personally. And just in general, you know, if you're going to do different things, think of just diversity, okay? You want to exercise. You want to dance. You want to socialize. You want to fill your life with happy moments. And dance is one of the happiest things you can do for yourself. And no, it doesn't have to be expensive. So if people think, oh, I can't afford, you don't have to do private lessons if you don't want to. You know?
And also, do you have to get all dressed? You know, people think you have to get all the little outfits and the shoes right at the beginning and
very good
all
question.
Of that. Is very that really question. Necessary?
There's only one thing that's necessary for, let's say, tango or just in general for a dance class, at least for salsa and tango. You need to have a proper shoes. Because in tango, if you're wearing flip-flops or something that sticks to the floor, it's very difficult to learn. Even on the first class, it's hard. So dance shoes that have a little bit of a slippery sole kind of and sit well on your foot, maybe a little heel, doesn't have to be high. That's about all the requirement you need to have to start
learning tango. I mean, and everybody probably has like a little black dress or something.
You don't have to.
You can still wear leggings and, you know, anything.
For classes, you don't have to dress up at all. There's tango events where everybody likes to dress up because they celebrate the whole tango culture. That's a different issue. But classes, you can come wearing anything you want. As long as you have sneakers are not the best thing to wear. Like I said, they stick to the floor. But other than that, you're good to go.
All right. Will you hear the music?
I love it.
So I guess Richard found your music. So when we come back, Alayna and I'm going to have her introduce her special guest because she's been sitting at the table with us through this whole time, and I think we want to introduce her and get her story told because it's very inspiring. right?
That's right. And this is one of the most inspiring people that I know through Tango community.
Oh,
and the next one is going to come up too.
This show is growing, everybody. It's all going to be Tango. So please stay with us. Alayna and I and the Tango gang will be right back. This is Alayna's Beauty Talk and More on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Starla Quarles, and I'm inviting you to join us every Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. for a new show right here on LA Talk Live, The Dialogue, Real Talk, Real People. Join us as we discuss the topics that are relevant to today's generational leaders. So don't forget to tune in to The Dialogue, Real Talk, Real People, every Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. right here on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, Live 365, Radio Flack, and now Stitcher Radio. Or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
People, it's Jennifer Tapier from StarCam. You guys might know me from the red carpet, catching up with all the stars, but guess what? We're bringing the red carpet to the radio right out here on LA Talk Live. I'm going live Thursday nights at 6 p.m. We got hot topics, celebrities, and much more. We were featured on Chloe Lamar on E!, Howard Stern, T.I.'s Family Hustle. You know how we do. So check it out on Thursday nights, 6 p.m. All things Hollywood, everything celebrity. StarCam Radio?
StarCam Radio?
StarCam Radio!
Oh yeah, follow us on Twitter, at StarCam Radio.
Hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson-Coppedge, and welcome to Joy in My House.
On LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio.
With a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid.
And no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Welcome back to Alayna's Beauty Talk and More. You can hear by the music. This is a show all about tango, getting you up, getting you moving, getting you dancing. I really wanted to, you know, do some inspiring shows, as I said earlier, through the month of January, because everybody wants to start the year off right. And what better way than to tango? You know, Dancing with the Stars is going to be coming back on. You'll get a head start of knowing what the tango is. And Alayna is always a wonderful guest. She's never without tons to say.
God knows that's
you
true.
You know, and I just got my voice back yesterday. So I was so excited knowing you were coming
oh, good.
Today, just in case my voice didn't come back.
Thank you.
Today.
It's wonderful to be on the show. I really love you.
Oh, yeah. And she's local. I mean, she doesn't have to drive really far. She actually lives
right.
in the area where our studio is.
That's right.
So it's very convenient. All right. We've got two people sitting at the table that are her guests. So I want Alayna to introduce them, give the audience a little bit of background on why you chose them to be guests on my show today.
That's right. These two people are my dearest, few of my dearest friends on the tango scene. We have met just dancing tango. We did not meet before. This is my dear friend Brenda, and she doesn't even go by last name anymore. She is Brenda Embrace Tango, okay? And there is a reason and story why. So she's going to share that with us a little bit later. And this is Howard Barsky, who is a dear, dear friend and a wonderful dancer. So glad you're here. So glad you could make it. That was great.
Oh, you got a good voice. I love it when we have men to break up our women's
Thanks for
voices.
That.
Yes. Did you do radio before?
No.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Yeah. New career. And they have a rich story, and they have a lot to offer, even just besides, dancing tango is just part of what they do and who they are. But these are truly wonderful, wonderful people. Howard and I have actually done some even workshops together.
Wonderful. That's great.
Yeah. So my life has been very much enriched by people like this. And
that's
this
what
is
tango
one of the benefits.
Does for you.
Yeah. Social dance, you'll probably make some of the best friends when you go out and start learning how to dance. So, yeah, these are my cherished people. Yes.
All right. So before we go on and into their stories, there were a few things you wanted to talk about.
Yeah. I wanted to share a little bit about what is unique when I started talking about why tango. I mean, why am I such a huge advocate of this particular dance? This dance will not only teach you how to dance, how to socialize, how to be more confident, how to be more balanced, how to, be coordinated and all of that great stuff. It will also teach you a lot about yourself, about how you are in relationships. Yeah, tango is a relationship dance. Yes? Can I hear an amen? It truly has all the elements about tango. You can literally take them straight from the dance floor and apply them to life, if that is sort of your mindset, because you can do all kinds of things and never learn anything but just the, fundamental, basic, top layer. But if you're open and you want your life to be better and you want to learn from your life experiences, tango is really a powerful teacher of how to relate to another person. For example, we're sort of slowly or maybe quickly approaching towards Valentine's Day. One of my biggest, my most favorite things to do is to use tango as a metaphor for a conscious, loving relationship. And I use Valentine's Day and time around it to have special workshops that teach people how to not only connect and ignite their passion and do that through tango, but also, when they dance together, some like issues come up. Like, for example, if a woman has to follow and she is sort of kind of controlling, she has a very hard time relinquishing control and surrendering to the man's lead. So people get to see how that plays out right on the dance floor. They don't think they're getting any therapy, but they are, because you have no choice. In order for two people to dance together as a team, one has to lead and the other one has to follow. And so for that to happen, a man has to really step into his beautiful masculine energy and not be, kind of wishy-washy and apologetic and like, I don't know if I'm being too forward or I'm, stepping on her feet or whatever. He needs to really engage beautiful, very solid masculine energy, but he has to combine it with caring, and we're going to talk about this.
Yes,
just
exactly.
Howard is a master of that. Combining that with this caring and considerate and loving energy. So it's sort of a mix of masculine and feminine, in a sense. And a woman has to be very much a active follower. Active doesn't mean she just hangs there and just kind of lets the men move her around. She has to be very much participating in being present, relinquishing control, trusting the man that's leading her. So there's a lot of life skills that are precious. And I use these skills in my background in spiritual psychology to do a little bit of life coaching at the same time. So that's sort of my specialty in a sense, and I'm going to do a lot of that around Valentine's Day. So
all right.
This is something I'm excited about.
If people want to reach you, why you? Because now you got them kind of excited.
Huh, hopefully.
What is your website?
It's called livingtango.com. So okay. Think of life and tango, and Living Tango is the name of my company.
Okay, because we'll give it out throughout the show, but I just thought it was a good spot because I liked what you had to say.
Livingtango.com, you will find me.
Yeah, that's the easiest way to find
Absolutely,
you.
Absolutely,
because everything's on your website. Yes. All right, let's get Brenda on the mic.
All right, so why do I have Brenda? And Brenda is truly, truly an inspiration to a lot of people. And
she has also been a guest on this show.
Yes, she has.
And on your website, that was a really popular video.
Yes, yes.
And
yes.
When we switched over how we were storing them,
they got sort of lost a little bit.
Yeah, so I said, why don't you have Brenda come back on so that we can... Here, there goes my voice.
Okay, I'll take over. Don't worry, take over. You want some water?
Yeah, you go.
Okay. Well, Brenda, thank you so much for coming because you drove all the way from Riverside and I really appreciate it. Yeah. Speaking of a person who did not look for convenience and did not look for a class like next door, Brenda travels in her car to go dancing anywhere and anytime she can, despite some of the inconveniences in her life. We'll call them just
minor.
Yes. So tell us a little bit. You know what? Tell us a little bit about when did you start dancing and what were the, you know, circumstances around that?
Everybody, before my voice is back for a minute, please listen to this story. It is so inspirational. Yes. And if you start to cry, that's okay. It's just an amazing, amazing story that I've taken with me since the last time you've been on the show.
Alayna mentioned bucket lists. We'll sort of start there. About 2005, I was running down the stairs one evening and hyperextended my leg, I thought. I missed the bottom three steps and the dog and ran to see what my daughter was needing me for. At that point, I had no clue that was going to be a life-changing moment. Through a series of a lot of tests and the rest, I found out I had something called synovial sarcoma. It's knee cancer. Mainly that comes out in men and boys from about the ages of 13 to 25. Not a 40-year-old something little old lady. So you sort of have a total new perspective on life. Through the treatment, chemo and radiation, of course, they said I was going to have the knot removed. But unfortunately, they had to take my leg. I'm an amputee. My level of amputation is 6.5 inches above my knee. So that makes walking extremely difficult. The bucket list. I want to learn to dance. Well, I never did when I had two legs. 2.5 years later, I was sitting in a hospital room bleeding internally, and a girlfriend walks in who has no legs, who's running in the Olympics. She ran this last Olympics, and she came in, I think it was, I don't remember if she medaled or not, and Katie, forgive me, but she taught me a life's long lesson. She's old enough to be my daughter, and yet she inspires me to get off my butt and to go and learn. About 2-3 days later, while she was training for running, somebody walked up and tapped her on the shoulder and said, "We're giving tango lessons. Do you know anybody that would like to come?" She says, "I think I know the right person." And that sort of started my journey into tango. A free lesson? I'll try anything once. Okay, I'm an amputee. I mean, all I can do is fall down, right? Well, I learned one thing, like Alayna was talking earlier about. Rhythm came back. Walking became easy. You learn so much more about relationships, why things work, why things don't. And does it really matter in 5 years, you know? That good old question. But I learned to do something most people won't do, is to get off the couch and try something. And they use the expert excuse, I have left feet. I have 3 or 4 of them at home, but I'm up dancing.
So there goes your excuse.
You have no more excuses, believe me.
Oh, I get a kick out of it. When she says she's got three or four, I'm like, okay.
So you do have like three or literally.
I only have literally three or four left feet.
Yeah, I mean, I really want people to understand that.
I should bring those in next time, huh?
Yeah, I mean, because.
They all have a garter belt on. I just want you to know, in fishnets.
No.
But you do have one with that.
I do have one.
Who made that for you?
Actually, the tangle, the prosthetic people make the leg, and then I just sort of adorn it.
That's right. So.
Yeah, so there. Like I said, it's just.
And how long have you been now an amputee and dancing?
I've been an amputee 7 years.
Oh, okay. I just got the signal. I guess I'm so into listening to you.
It's a great story to break down.
I didn't even hear. Okay, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to still continue with Brenda to get some life lessons about dance and tango and any other things she wants to talk about because it's so inspiring. I think we need to hear things like that from real people.
That's right.
We don't really hear enough. You know, we always have excuses why we can't. So.
This is as real as it gets.
Yeah, so we're going to come right back. Alayna. Oh, I just lost everybody's name.
Brenda and Howard.
I have it sitting right in front of me.
That's right.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. Yeah, this sinus thing's kind of gone to my head. I went through a red light on the way here. Anyway, we're going to take a break. This is Alayna's Beauty Talk and More on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
Thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.
Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple nonstop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live. Walk, run, climb, play. Solgar number 7 can help. Feel the difference for yourself. Solgar number 7 actually shows improvement in joint comfort within 7 days. Now you can start to get back on track fast and pursue the activities you love. Solgar number 7 is a breakthrough in joint care with no glucosamine and no chondroitin. The advanced bioactives in Solgar number 7 help to increase flexibility, mobility, range of motion, and actually shows improvement within just 7 days. One capsule once a day is all you need. When stiff joints occasionally say no, Solgar number 7 says yes. Visit Solgar.com and learn more about Solgar number 7 today. That's www.solgar.com, www.solgar.com. Solgar number 7, official sponsors of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane and LA Talk Live.
Hi, this is Starla Quarles, and I'm inviting you to join us every Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. for a new show right here on LA Talk Live, The Dialogue, Real Talk, Real People, Join us as we discuss the topics that are relevant to today's generational leaders. So don't forget to tune in to The Dialogue, Real Talk, Real People, every Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. right here on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, and now Stitcher Radio. Or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Welcome back to Alayna's Beauty Talk and More. You can hear our beautiful tango music playing in the background. I want Brenda to come back up to the mic. She's such an amazing story. We were just talking about you being an amputee and how you have, what, 4 or 5 legs at home?
No, I have feet.
Oh, feet?
Yes, it's the feet.
It's left feet. Left feet or yes. Left foot?
Left foot.
But I have lots of feet.
Correct. So you can't use that excuse with me that, you know, I have 2 left feet. It's like I have 4 at home. So, you know, get up and dance. And people look at you funny and you say, get up and dance. Yeah, well, get up and start moving, start walking around, live your life.
How long have you been an amputee now?
Since 2006.
Okay, so it's almost 7 years.
Just about 7 years.
And are you going back for another surgery? Is that what I heard through the grapevine? Is this related to your leg or something different?
No, it's totally something different. It's something that a lot of women do have, thyroid issues.
And okay.
So like I said, it's a blessing in disguise. It was actually found through one of my regular scans for my cancer that I did have a problem, and they've been watching it. Now it's time to go. Well, it's still not cancer-ish.
Yeah. So that, now, how old's your daughter now?
She is 21.
Wow. She has to be very proud of you.
I believe she is. She's still at that age where I don't want to talk to mom. You know, I mean, as children grow and grow, there's times that they want their mother in their life, and there's times that they don't.
And it does happen.
It does happen, and she will eventually be around.
Yeah, I've had my own share of challenges raising my 2 kids, so I can relate to this a little bit. We are now on the clear and doing great. Yeah. So the day will come.
It just takes time. Oh, well, like I said, did I say I was the same prodigy like my mother? Yeah, my mother and I were very, very close too at the end, I should say. But, you know, we had a time of estrangement. I think all people do. You want to become your own person. You don't want to live in someone else's shadow. And then when they would when they have challenges or difficulties of their own, you don't want to take upon those. And no parent wants to transfer that to their child either. So it's you find support and support groups for that. And I'm very fortunate. I have an amputee support group that is amazing. We do all sorts of things. And like Alayna says,
including dance classes.
Including
well,
the dance
now
classes.
What other things do you do besides tango, which is your love?
Well, tango's my new love, I should say. I'm actually an advocate for people with cancer as well as people that are amputees. I'm a peer support person. So if you are facing an amputation, I'm the person that they call after the surgery.
How can
or before.
They get in touch with you?
Basically through the Amputee Connection or Amputee Connections in Riverside, Redlands, and Corona. Basically, we have a website out there. We're in our fundraiser right now. We are going to be it's called Tour de Palm Springs. It's the weekend, I think, before Valentine's Day. But we raise money to send our children, and I say our children, I'm not their parent, but amputee children to summer camp up in Big Bear in June. And it's expensive. A lot of the children will never have an opportunity to go and to be with their peers because they aren't accepted a lot of times to regular camps because of the limitations. So you have to go to a special camp.
Wow.
So it's very, very fun. But our goal this year, I believe, is to raise $10,000. And there's 30 of us. And so it's everybody's doing their part. Like I said, I was just happened to come today, and Alayna had no clue.
Great. Yeah.
No, this is real. I love things like this. This is very important to me.
Like I said, if anybody wants to donate to that, I would appreciate it. They can go through the website. They can contact Alayna. She knows how to get a hold of me, so we'll make sure we can get that.
But what do you know your website?
I believe it's theamputeeconnection.com or connections. I can't remember. I'm sorry. And I don't, I can look
or livingtango.com Living Tango, and I will find her. Yes. So livingtango.com, I will redirect people. That would be wonderful.
I definitely would appreciate it. Like I said, we're sending children to summer camp this year, and that's part of our goal. We are a nonprofit. We are a 501(c). So I believe I said that were correct. And so like I said, it's something that I also feel very, very passionate about because I do give tango lessons. Last October, we were at the Cal State San Bernardino, and I believe I'll be teaching again this year.
Oh, that's so exciting. Isn't that amazing? It's great.
You learn by doing. You improve by doing. The more you're out, the more you improve. I ran into Alayna, literally, she was teaching tango on the streets.
Yes, I was. Third Street Promenade in Santa Monica when we were promoting tango, and that's how we met. I took pictures of her. I was like standing there going, wow, she's on stage. She's dancing with a partner with a prosthesis. I mean, I was so moved and touched. I could not believe it. I still have the videos. I was so just inspired.
That was sort of my coming out party that day, in tango, because most people had not met me at that point. And there's still a lot of people that I know, I see on the floor, I dance, you know, they're intimidated because I'm different. And that's okay. You know, one day they'll get the nerve to dance with me, but that's all right. You know, it takes both of it because I have to be where I can dance with them as well because it's a spatial issue and a weight, because it's a weight change. Walking, you literally are controlled falling when you learn to walk, and especially in a prosthetic. So I'm taking baby steps and it's learning. And entangle feet, or your feet, how do you explain this, Alayna? Your feet replace somebody else's foot where you just left in time and
space?
Yeah,
tango is a very unique walk. And so speaking of taking it down to the basics, she really needed to almost relearn how to walk, not only just because she had to relearn how to walk, but also in tango, there's a certain way of walking. A number one, you have to brush your feet through ankles and knees, like neutral position. So you're not walking in two separate lines. You're walking sort of in one line. So that is actually very hard.
And you're
going to
kind of demonstrate a little bit.
Yeah, we will talk about a few elements.
Like in 15, 20 minutes.
But
we'll
go
over to the demonstration area.
When you tell someone, I've learned to walk four times, over and over and over, do you think you've got it? Well, I mean, people with two legs say, well, it's easy. You just get up and walk. Well, you think about everything that you do. Life is that way. Challenges you meet, you exceed, and you just blow through.
Are there more people than we know that are amputees? I mean, is it, especially now with people coming back from, you know, the war, do you get in contact with them?
I get in contact with a lot of different people. The main person is a diabetic person. They've lost a limb, they've lost toes, they've lost fingers. Mm-hmm. They've lost something because of their dietary, what they do. You know, I mean, you can't help it sometimes. Yeah. It's an illness. And your blood sugar gets uncontrolled, or you get a wound, it gets infected. By the time you get to the doctor, you're going to lose your foot. You're going to lose a leg. And a lot of times I'll see a person on more than one occasion because it starts off with a foot and it travels up the leg. Maybe it becomes to a second one. And at that point, you know it's unfortunate, but it happens. And what do? They go sit in a wheelchair. They sit and they get depressed. And if you sit,
I'm sure your other muscles get atrophied.
Everything, that's besides the point.
It takes so long to build a muscle, but it takes no time to lose it.
Yeah,
so,
exactly. I mean, I've been out of the gym 3 or 4 days with this sinus, and I could already see my muscles.
So yeah, this happens. So obviously, a much better choice than as soon as you can move, find something that inspires you and moves you, and then you get caught up in that moment and you forget.
All right, let's get Howard on the mic.
Yes,
so that we can do this.
Hi, Howard.
Hi, Howard.
Hi there. It's good to have some male energy here. This tango takes two to tango.
Yeah,
male and female energy.
We're getting too female-y here.
Yeah. Hi, Howard.
Hi there.
Good to have you.
Nice.
If I may ask a question, because I know this man really well, so I know his background. He's shared some of the wonderful insights with me and my students as well. We do occasional workshops.
Right.
And it's interesting. Howard, how long ago did you start learning tango?
I started about 16 or 17 years ago.
That was a long time.
Yeah, right.
Yes, but here's a kicker. Would you be comfortable sharing what age you were when you started learning?
Well,
you can do the math after that.
Okay. I would be, This is 2012. So that would be
13. Hello.
2013. Excuse me. Well, everybody else.
We're in denial.
I'm 82 now, so subtract.
You look amazing.
This man is 82, okay? Yes, he deserves the applause. Thank you.
A big applause.
Thank you, thank you.
So whatever the starting year is, whatever that is. So.
Yeah, okay, so fine. Never mind that.
Late 60s, basically, yeah, early 70s.
Yeah.
Late 60s.
Why tango, by the way? I'm just curious. Why tango?
I have a niece who drives me everywhere thinking I'd be interested in this or that. And she's one of the people who takes you somewhere and say how exciting it is. Then after 2 weeks, you're there and she's gone.
Yeah, that's cute.
Well, anyways, I learned. I got very intrigued with tango and kept up with lessons and then got more and more into it. And
now let me ask you right there. How much time do you spend in Buenos Aires in the last, 16 years or whatever you said? How many times were you there?
I've been there approximately 12 times over the last 6 or 7 years. It was very scared about everything you hear about Buenos Aires and the level of dancing there and how you ask people to dance and the women really have the control over who they want to dance with.
Ah.
So I was very scared going there. So I waited at least 5 or 6 years until I had been dancing 5 or 6 years before I went there the first time, and it became very exciting. It's just a total, not only the tango here being an addiction, but there even more so.
You see, we didn't mention that. See, tango, Argentine tango, truly is not a stage dance. What you usually see when you watch performances like Dancing with the Stars and other performances, that's a choreographed, beautiful thing for people to to entertain. Argentine tango is a street dance. It was born in the slums of Buenos Aires. Okay, so we go back to the slums.
Here we are.
To revisit the culture, and of course, it has changed and transformed tremendously over the years. But it's a street dance. It's a dance that allows two people, complete strangers most often, get together without speaking each other. Now, Howard speaks beautiful Spanish.
But you don't need to. I've been in Europe dancing too, and I don't speak French, don't speak Italian, and there was never needed a word.
And you have been in few countries and danced.
Yes, and
now, do you dance professionally or do you just dance for fun?
Not at all, just for fun. I've been asked to teach, and I know I just love dancing. I've done it all my life.
Before tango,
I started like 8 years out of high school dancing swing, and I still enjoy doing that once in a while. And I went into salsa for a while, rumba, cumbia, and so on, but.
So you always a dancer?
I'd always loved dancing personally. I always had a picture of Fred Astaire on my bedroom wall, and so dancing has always been a
music.
Passion for me.
See, he's also a huge fan of music.
Too.
Yeah.
For a profession, you're an artist.
It's more of a hobby. I do sell pieces, but fortunately, I don't have to rely on it for a living.
And what did you do, or you probably still do?
I was a product design, industrial design.
Okay.
And then I got into retail business, graphics and advertising and so on. But I'm retired now for the last 5-6 years. So I've been able to devote my time to a wonderful family, a wife of over 50 years.
Does she dance with you?
No, she... She chose. We took lessons together right at the beginning, and she chose not to continue. She, for her own reasons, decided that it was not for her. And I became totally embroiled in the dance and continued with it, and have just. It's become really so much a part of my life that it's fulfilled so many of my needs and so many wonderful aspects of my life that it just.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I wanted to have this show today, to really inspire people.
Inspiring.
They don't hear real stories like this very often, coming from the heart.
It's truly true life transforming.
You know, we read them, or, you'll read it in a blog, but really, I think hearing it, and for those of you watching us on Ustream, you get to see that they're real people.
And this is just a couple of people.
I mean, this could have brought another 10, you know? Yeah, we could have filled this whole room two times over.
One of my dearest friends, who is dance salsa, has was like a man that felt like he couldn't even talk to a woman. I mean, he was very, very large, you know, basically borderline obese, and just in general very shy, insecure. His life changed. I mean, the man dances with every gorgeous woman on salsa scene. He's, I mean, I had an interview with him as well. I love seeing stories like this because, you know, if you're feeling sorry for yourself or insecure, there is a cure for that. And you don't have to go to a therapist necessarily. I mean, I don't knock therapy. I like therapy. But the point is, dance is therapy. And it's painless. It's fun.
What I found in moving through all the different kind of dances as I got older and became one of the older persons on the different dance scenes, even in salsa and in moving into tango, that I found it was the least ageism dance.
Discriminatory, around. Yes.
Yeah, yes. It was the least problem. Many times I've laughed and discussed it with the dance partner that she was probably the youngest person at this dance place, and I was the oldest. We were dancing together.
And that there's pictures of most
and
amazing.
And how many nights a week or days a week do you still dance?
Two to three nights a week. At a certain period of time, about 6 years ago, I was going six nights a week.
And where are your favorite places to go?
Well, they're all over. Yeah, Ilona's Milonga. The Milonga is a dance.
Right across the street from you here.
Right across
there's
the
a
street
new,
here.
New event.
That we'll talk about that. Okay.
Definitely. Once a month, Sundays. Yeah. That's a great place. And there's some old Milongas on Saturday night. There's a place called El Encuentro.
Right. The Tango
there's,
Room.
There's once a month Milongas are starting to spring up now. And those are very enjoyable. Instead of going to the same place every week.
Yes, it's nice to mix up.
Once a month ones are really getting more enjoyable. They get larger crowds.
It's really fun. It's growing hugely. We only used to have, like 15 years ago, like a couple of places to go. Now we have a lot.
Tell people what a Milonga is, because I didn't know what it was.
Good question.
I mean, I know the word now because you've been on my show for a couple years, but I never knew that word.
Yes. Well, let's break it down real quick. Milonga has two meanings. Milonga is the name of a dance, just like tango, that is actually an older sister of tango that was a precursor. And it's faster and it's a little bit slightly different, has a more of a playfulness to it.
More of a poker
kind of a feeling.
More polka.
But also milonga applies to a dance social. So it's a tango party. So when we say we're going to a milonga, that means that we're going to a club. It's the same exact word that's used all over the world. So milonga is a place where you go to dance. Yeah. And the people come from all over the world.
And your milonga is like once a month. They're free most of the time? Okay. You go through that because I don't want to give out wrong information.
One of the things I did in the last year that has become really, really good and popular, and I'm really proud of it, is an event I started in South Bay. It's the closest one in South Bay. It is called Milonga LAX because it's literally steps away from LAX. It's located across the street from this station, actually, right? And it happens on the first Sunday of each month, and it starts with a free introductory class for absolutely anyone. No strings attached, no partner needed, left feet, right feet, Come on down.
Is there one soon then?
That was just one last Sunday, and the next one is on February 3rd.
Okay.
So every first Sunday of the month, I put it out to all the local newspapers to remind people, and last time we had like 40 people that came and just tried tango for the first time. It was amazing. It's beautiful.
And you teach it?
I teach it, yes. Okay. I teach it. I love beginners, and I have great passion for what I do.
Ilona is a great teacher, really warm and loving.
Yeah. I love it, yeah. So it's very successful, and I invite anyone who wants to give it a try, just check it out.
And what
look
time
for
is it usually?
Sundays at 6 to 7 p.m. No traffic, no nothing. You come out. It's a gorgeous place. There is free parking for everyone.
Where is it?
Milonga LAX, located at L.A. Turner Center, basically on the corner of Sepulveda and Westchester. So right next to LAX sign, okay? Mm-hmm. Howard is there very often. Brenda comes down whenever she can. Last time we had about 120 people dancing in that room. It was gorgeous. We also have food. I create this whole environment and ambiance. And We also have performances because I like to bring different social dancing.
So it's more than an hour?
It goes, the dancing part starts from 7 and goes to 11:30. And then all of that is involved. But the class is from 6 to 7, free class, and you don't have to stay. Milonga itself is like $12 to stay, but, you know, parking is free and we provide some refreshments and stuff like that. So
it's still not expensive.
No, not at all. Because, well, people who go dancing tango go like 5-6 times a week. Can you imagine what it would be like if we had to pay a lot more every single night? You need to have two jobs.
It's something that provides so much personally to me and all the people that go there. It's sort of, I don't know.
It's physical therapy for me.
Totally.
It's therapy. It's an emotional high, a combination of mental gratification.
Physical gratification.
Physical gratification.
Because you're in great shape.
Emotional. It just combines all of them together. And it just.
Well, what they don't know, Howard, is that we dance in a close embrace.
Yeah.
You get hugs.
So you get hugs. You're dancing hug the entire time. Mm-hmm. So if you have issues with hugging people, you may have a hard time at first, but it's going to be so good for you because the connection, the human connection, is so healing. See, so part of tango and the beauty of this dance is that we dance in this embrace, like we've known each other for years, like we really care about one another. And it's not about romantic connection per se, although people perceive that tango is all about romance and drama and that, you know, on a dance floor, it's more about connecting and sharing this beautiful, loving energy, creativity, and creating a dance that is actually improvisational in nature. So it's not choreographed and rehearsed.
Yeah, see,
it's
changing. Everybody thinks it's like Dancing with the
exactly.
Stars.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
It's fun to dance.
Go ahead, Brandon.
It's fun to dance. I don't know what he's telling me I'm going to do. So
next moment,
if you
yeah.
like a challenge, tango definitely is for you in that aspect because I am in this embrace with this gentleman who I've just met, or I may have known him for a long time.
Yeah.
But I don't know what – I can't read his mind. I don't know where my feet are going to go. And the cool thing is – he gives me those clues from his embrace, what he'd like for me to do. And he asks me to do. It's the introduction, right?
I'd like to give a little example.
Please.
Of what the close embrace is like. I was given this by a teacher many years ago. She said, suppose you walk into a room and you're standing there in one corner of the room, and at the other corner of the door, a woman walks in that turned out to have been your lover 2 or 3 years ago, and you parted on really good terms. But you haven't seen each other for 2 or 3 years. Anyways, you walk together and give each other one of those kind of hugs like, oh, my God, I've missed you so.
And that's how you dance.
Mm-hmm. And that's at that point, you just raise your arms up and hold the woman and start dancing. She said, that's the close embrace.
That's embrace.
But see, this what's unique about it is that it feels this way, but you can learn to embrace people just for who they are.
Yeah, without
it
that
doesn't
being,
have to be romantic.
Without that being
doesn't,
the situation.
Yes. Yeah. So that's the beauty of social dance is you dance with people you may not even would have picked to talk to mm-hmm. in the outside of the dance floor. It has nothing to do with neither physical attraction, nor do you make enough money for me to dance with you, nor where do you live, or none of that really matters. You share that moment, that dance, and that's all that matters.
Wow.
Powerful.
It's very powerful.
Can't beat it.
The nice thing about it, it's the connection with two. So you don't have that connection with anybody else. And it may only be for that 3 or 4 minutes of time. It can go a whole tanda.
Yeah, the tanda, they don't know. Tanda is a block of four tangos. You're committed to a block of four dances, not one, like in salsa. It's like, in salsa, it's like, oh, yeah, great dance. See ya. In tango, it almost becomes this little short-term relationship. So you are dancing four dances. Then there is a break that allows everyone to separate, say thank you, goodbye. The music that comes in is called cortina, which is a total different music unrelating to tango. Everybody gently says thank you, moves on to the next partner. But it's three, four dances in a block, and it's called tanda.
It's a commitment. It's a nice commitment.
Commitment.
And sometimes that's the longest commitment you'll ever have.
That's awesome. That's right, exactly.
And, but for others?
And sometimes you don't want it to end.
That's it. And others that you don't want.
All right, I'm having a coughing fit.
Uh-oh. Can we have some tango music, please?
Yeah.
Milonga. Like, that's like a milonga, by the way. Right on.
Take us to break. All right.
All right. We're going to take a short break, and we're going to come back and continue this wonderful, fun conversation. And we'll even possibly give you a little demonstration, at least, of what embrace looks like. Okay?
All right.
All right.
Walk, run, climb, play. Solgar No. 7 can help. Feel the difference for yourself. Solgar No. 7 actually shows improvement in joint comfort within 7 days. Now you can start to get back on track fast and pursue the activities you love. Solgar No. 7 is a breakthrough in joint care with no glucosamine and no chondroitin. The advanced bioactives in Solgar No. 7 help to increase flexibility, mobility, range of motion, and actually shows improvement within just 7 days. One capsule, once a day, is all you need. When stiff joints occasionally say no, Solgar No. 7 says yes. Visit Solgar.com and learn more about Solgar No. 7 today. That's www.solgar.com, www.solgar.com. Solgar No. 7, official sponsors of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane and LA Talk Live.
Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple nonstop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 Fourth Top Realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.
Oh, your skin looks great.
Thank you.
What's your secret?
Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence.
Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence?
Yes, it's a beauty secret used since the time of the Greeks and Romans. The spa in Malibu told me about frankincense and myrrh by Ancient Essence, and now my skin is lovely.
Well, your skin looks great.
Call Ancient Essence at 1-800-627-9813. Discover the secret of beautiful skin. Call 1-800-627-9813. Discover the secret. Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence. Discover the secret of beautiful skin. Available at fine spas and beauty centers.
Welcome back to Alayna's Beauty Talk and More. My voice is back for a few minutes. Thank you, Alayna, for filling in. I just lost my voice there. We've been talking tango, all the benefits of tango, everything tango. So we're going to sit at the table for the next little while, kind of wrap up the discussion, see where it goes. And then the Tango people are going to do a short demonstration because I want everybody to see Brenda's leg. I want people to watch Howard move. I mean, you know, you got to walk the walk, you know. We can't just sit at the table.
Sadly, we don't unfortunately have a hardwood floor, and that is actually a requirement. But we will do the best we can under the circumstances.
Oh, just a fun little demo.
Yeah, we will try to do some. Yes, I just want to, again, remind you guys, I have two amazing friends here, Howard Barsky and Brenda Embrace Tango. And thank you guys for being here.
You're welcome. Thank you.
These two people always bring a smile to my face when I see them. It like literally feels like family, truly. When you dance with people in a close embrace a lot, you feel like you're almost related, really. It is, you know, I always tease Brenda as she, my boyfriend, my partner, is learning, and he's been dancing for only like 3 years, and he's getting better and better, and he's now on the, you know, dancing a lot socially. And every time he dances with her, I take pictures of them, and I always, you know, shake my finger, go, you take it easy, because, you know, you got to get your own.
I always tell him I'm warming him up to send him home with her, though. But you know, it's a cool thing about tango is the seriousness and the not so seriousness. We're both learning, and we both learn from each other. Yeah. But yet he can take that back, what he's learned with me, and go back to her, and he's doing new steps.
He's also like realizing, for example, for him, he's shared this with me, he's realizing that when he, for example, dances with Brenda, he has to be extremely aware of A, what she can and cannot do, how she moves. He, as a good leader, has to adjust to every follower he's dancing with. This is a social dance. See, so they haven't practiced. They don't practice. They don't dance together, but maybe once in a blue moon. And so a good leader in general, think about it, just even in life, a good leader is someone who checks in with a follower. They're not just like, I am the leader and everybody follows me and I don't care how you feel, what you do, where your head is, how your body. You really, really have to tune in because it's a teamwork.
That's one of the major things is for the leaders really to show how much they care for the person they're dancing with by being aware of where they are and what they're capable of or not capable of.
Exactly.
And not be there just to show off what you know.
Yeah. It's very, very important. This is why if you have a good follower, and I said before, follower brings something very unique to the table. A follower is not just a follower, okay? I just do what you tell me. It's I can tune into you. I can give myself to you completely and fully. My attention is only with you, and I'm going to mirror what your suggestions are and what your cues are, and we're going to create this dance in the moment. Like she becomes almost like a brush in a painter's hand, and they paint a painting together.
Together, for
okay?
sure.
That's how it, I mean, Howard is a painter. He knows what that means.
After a few years of dancing, the most exciting part is when I started realizing the woman could give this feedback of now, wait a second, give me a little bit longer pause. Is there something I want to do here?
In order to do a special move that looks really sensuous or beautiful,
that
he has
really
to slow
exciting.
down, and he has to give her time, and he has to be in tune that she's actually conveying this, hey, slow down. How do you feel that? You're not saying, hey, slow down. You're saying it with your body.
It's totally in the embrace and how you're holding each other.
Definitely. And then, like I said, I add the unique challenge to the mix with my leg because it only will react a certain way. And that's what her friend is always teasing me about because he's understanding that, oh, wait a minute, I can't do that. Here's your leg and we're going to be over there if I do it that way. So let's slow it down. Let's move it here.
That's right.
And it works. And being able to have that change, that pause, or the moment just to let it react because my leg actually does some very unique things that we've learned.
Sort of its own things, you know,
it
sometimes.
Its own things.
It's really interesting. And I also wanted to share a cute story. I shared it with my class just recently. When I met with my boyfriend who came into my class, actually, and because I said for people with left feet, that was the only thing that attracted him. He said that was like your mating call. Anyway, so he came into my class and he's now, we've been together in the most beautiful relationship for 3 years. And he asked me, why do I love dancing? I mean, you know, from an outside perspective, you go like, I mean, you know, they're like hot young guys. I'm sorry. I'm just explaining how people think. Like, okay, you're dancing with an older man who doesn't seem to be doing a whole lot on the dance floor. He's very contained. He's minimal. So he's thinking, you know, typical thinking, like, wouldn't you be rather dancing with somebody who is flamboyant and throws you around and stuff, you know? So he's like, what is it about, Howard, that you love to dance? And I said, you know what? You need to go and ask Howard what it takes and why he's so popular on the dance floor. And he did. He actually, this is what I love about the man I'm dating, is he went and he humbled himself and he went and asked, Howard, what is it that you do? And Howard said,
I said, you have to show the woman that you're dancing with how much you care for her by how careful you are with her. And how much you show that careness by being
in that
very thoughtful and allowing not be there to show the steps that you know how to do, but to be aware of her in every way, how you hold her, not overly tight,
controlling just, or not yeah, controlling, exactly,
and without saying a word, just in your embrace and how you dance with her.
Now, do you talk at all during the time you're dancing?
Hopefully not.
Hopefully not, because it actually diffuses the energy that you create. It's not about talking.
A couple of times a woman started the conversation in the middle, and by the end of that dance, I forgot I'd been dancing with her.
Exactly.
It just destroys the whole concept.
Yeah, you create this energy exchange. It's more about that. It's not so much. You can talk afterwards, and you can talk in a break. And
in between
like
the dances
this.
Or
yes,
afterwards.
Yes, yes, yes. But I remember clearly Baram coming back to me and saying, he said something about the fact that when you hold a woman, you have to make her feel like nothing else exists.
Exactly.
And I said, wow. And he said, I think I can do that.
And
I looked
does.
At him, and I was like, no, but this was before we really started a relationship. I'm like, okay, I'm going to have to see that. Apparently, we've been together for 3 years. So, yes, he does. Yes, but this was priceless advice. I so appreciate that.
One time on my first trip to Buenos Aires, I was dancing with a woman. And occasionally, you see someone around the perimeter of the dance floor. And with my right hand, it was behind the woman. I sort of slightly waved. And my partner could feel that I was doing that. And she told me immediately, she says, when you're dancing with me, do not flirt with anybody else.
So there's a tough one for men, because there's a lot of options, there's a lot of choices. But when you dance together in the social dance, because it's a response and cue and response, a constant exchange, you have to be fully present only for this partner at that time.
Nothing like it in any other dance. This connection that you've established in tango.
Some people don't know how to do it in life.
No.
They don't know how to connect to a person for one date. I mean, they can barely sit through like one date or whatever. We have to learn how to give ourselves to people, even if it's for a moment or for a long time, whatever, how to give our full presence. It's a gift. And we have to learn to do that. And to me, that's one of the most powerful things that tango taught us. It nails you to that present moment, and you got no place to run.
Wow.
One of the things that developed, I guess, mainly from the European community and the Argentinian or Latin community is the kind of closeness, besides the embrace, when you greet people, there's a hug and a kiss on the cheek.
Mm-hmm.
Automatically.
That's very un-American.
And even the first time you've met somebody,
you
give them the hug and the kiss. And it just develops as people come into the dances, the milongas. That's what you see, everybody hugging and talking and kissing, and even for the first time you've met somebody. And it's such a wonderful,
warm feeling.
It's
so warm. You know, if you don't have family or you don't have kids or you don't, you know, this is how you find and create that extended family. And I just wanted you to know, there are classes to learn how to dance. If you don't feel drawn to tango, God bless you. Learn how to dance something else. But get out there. You know, I teach at Third Street Dance in LA that has offers all kinds of classes. It's not just tango. And I teach on Tuesdays, every Tuesday tango. That's like right across from the Beverly Center. It's a very, very popular studio because there's a lot of practicing of Dancing with the Stars. This is their prime location. I teach, my home base kind of is in the South Bay. So I teach in El Segundo at the Studio Art of Dance. I am going to be offering beautiful special workshops for very unique workshops for Valentine's Day that will probably, not probably, definitely have little champagne and chocolates and even blindfolds. Don't ask me more. But anyway, livingtango.com. And there are other resources in LA. One is called Tango Aficionado that has all resources for all different milongas and classes and teachers. But mine is livingtango.com. Check it out. Visit. Hope I see you on the dance floor.
Probably will see some people. All right, that's our music. So we're going to take a break. Howard, Brenda, and Alayna are going to go over and give us a short demonstration. We're going to close out the show kind of dancing, I think.
Yeah, we're going to attempt. We're going to try to move.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, but we have to show. Well, I want everybody to
see. We'll see. We'll
see
what we can do, and we'll do the best we can. Yes.
You always say that.
No, know? Because I always bring tango shoes. I know. And I actually bring, you know.
Yeah,
so
last
we do
time
it
we had your tango shoes all over the table.
Collection. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Tango shoes are hot. They are another addiction.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, tango clothes are an addiction once you get going.
Yeah.
But that's the fun of it.
It is. It is.
That's the fun of it. All right. We're to go into a break. This is Alayna's Beauty Talk and more. And we will be right back. So stay tuned, everybody.
Yes.
Thank you for tuning into LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network, original reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk. Stay tuned.
People, it's Jennifer Tapier from StarCam. You guys might know me from the red carpet, catching up with all the stars. But guess what? We're bringing the red carpet to the radio right out here on LA Talk Live. I'm going live Thursday nights at 6 p.m. We got hot topics, celebrities, and much more. We were featured on Chloe Lamar on E!, Howard Stern, T.I.'s Family Hustle. You know how we do. So check it out on Thursday nights, 6 p.m. All things Hollywood, everything celebrity. StarCam Radio.
StarCam Radio.
StarCam Radio.
Oh yeah, follow us on Twitter at StarCam Radio.
Hi everyone, Chef Richard Petty here to tell you about LA Talk Live's new cookie show, Let's Do Lunch, with me, your host, Chef Richard Petty. Let's Do Lunch launches Saturday, January 19th at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Well, tune in to Let's Do Lunch with me, Chef Richard Petty, Saturdays, 10 to 11 a.m., exclusively on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
Hi, this is Nick Cordelai Corte inviting you to join me Sundays at 10 a.m. right here on LA Talk Live for our all-new show, People Are Talking. Join us as we offer you a weekly dose of fresh perspectives with in-studio guests, hot topics in the world of politics and pop culture, and the voices of everyday people impacted by the political issues coming to a ballot box near you. So don't forget to tune in to People Are Talking exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, watch us on Ustream.tv, or even catch us under the Radio Flags app under ILATK. reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson-Coppage, and welcome to Joy in My House
on LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio
with a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid
and no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Welcome back to Alayna's Beauty Talk and More. You can see we are getting ready to do just a short little tango demonstration just so you can get the feel of it. I want everybody to see Brenda, how brave she's been with her leg. You know, her leg was under the table, so you really didn't get a chance to see it. And I know Alayna's going to want to post this, as do I, up on our pages. So I really want to finish it so people really know about her leg and the amputee and how much she donates her time to work with amputees.
Yes.
So, Alayna, take the mic.
All right. Thank you. So we're here, you know, to try and show you a little bit of the essence of what tango is all about. It's a little bit challenging to do demonstration, as we actually need dance shoes and a hardwood floor because it requires a little bit of kind of a slipping motion. But we're going to show you, for example, Howard and Brenda are going to demonstrate, number one, dance embrace, okay? Why do we love tango embrace? And guys, can you do me a favor also and maybe turn around because they can't see this arm? So maybe you can actually sort of rotate and yes. And okay, so if you can see, Howard is actually embracing her entirely all the way across the back. And this arm is just a really beautiful supportive arm. When I teach that embrace, I always talk about the fact that the man holds his arm out as if he's playing a violin. So it's kind of outside of your body. And she's actually kind of leaning a little bit towards him so that he, when he projects his energy from the upper part of his body, a chest, which is kind of a heart center, he's going to move her to walk, okay? So he's going to lead her from the chest, and she's going to step back. And I don't know if you can see her feet or her legs, but she's going to mimic and simply mirror the size and his steps. So she's not moving on her own. He's the one moving her by leading her, okay? Now, for Brenda, she had to almost have her... she needed to have her leg made in such a way that she could do certain tango moves that otherwise amputees can't do. And that is, for example, what we call a cruzada. It's a cross step for the woman. In order for her to cross, she has to be able, yes, it's right there. So she crosses a left foot over the right, and that is a signature step of tango called cruzada. And she needs to be able to do that. Now, as I'm concerned for your safety, Brenda, okay, because your shoe is being untied, I don't want you to trip. So I want you, yes, so let's untangle for a second so that you can fix that. And I'm going to take over. Yeah, go ahead, yes. And maybe I can ask you for a favor, and maybe I need someone to hold the mic so I can continue the demonstration if you don't mind. Is that okay?
Thank you.
my God, it looked like you could have danced the rest of the night. You look like you were just, like, so into it.
All right. Yeah.
Well, so this was just literally a sample of social dancing. We were.
Wow, you're out of breath a little bit.
Ah, I was holding the breath. It was just such a lot. It's always, you get lost in the moment.
I know. It's like, okay, do I interrupt them? But they look like they're having such a good time.
It's very intimate, and it's actually challenging because for the fact that I don't know what he's going to do next moment. So I'm literally
when
just
when was the last
following.
Time you danced with him?
Maybe a few weeks ago.
Yeah, 2 weeks.
A few weeks ago. I mean, we occasionally dance. We always love it. Okay, come forward a little bit. Okay, great. So, yeah, so this was a really, really a demonstration of what bread and butter dance looks like on the dance floor. We didn't do anything fancy. So the things that's required is just a man knowing what he wants to do and being decisive about it, being able to convey that message and tell the woman what he wants her to do next. Takes a little while to learn.
There's this confidence factor, I think, for both men and women. That you get to a certain point that, you know, up to this point, you're not sure that you can do it. So you, the way you dance is like you're not sure. But once you pass that point, you exude this kind of confidence in how you hold a woman and how you lead. And I think it's for the woman the same thing.
Yeah. All right, it doesn't look like he was doing a lot, right? But right. The thing is, this was truly a lovely dance. And although we're here, it's not really comfortable necessarily to dance with a dance floor. It was enjoyable even on that level. It was great because we have a great connection. And so you can't miss out. You can't lose. And it's for anyone. You don't have to have any background. And if you want to learn how to dance tango, check out dance lessons all over LA. And my website is called livingtango.com. Again, there will be Valentine's Day classes, also with relationship a little bit focus. And there's many places to go dance tango. Mine is just one, Milonga LAX. And there's also all kinds of milongas in all areas, Santa Monica, the Valley. So it's all on the web. You can find us all. Just look Argentine Tango in LA.
Wow. Is
that good enough? Yes.
Yeah, so I just got the sign, so we have to wrap up the show. So there, hand Brenda the mic. I want her to give out the website for the amputees to send them to camp.
It's the Amputee Connections in Riverside, Redlands, and Corona. You can look us up on the web as well. We are on Facebook. We do have a link to PayPal there, and please give a donation. Please put what you saw here on LA Live so we know that where actually the donation came from, because we do send out thank yous and we do appreciate it. So do the children, because it is their opportunity to get to go to camp. And also the remainder also does help support our group. So we are no fees paid by the amputees, so we can actually go out and do other support to other people as well.
That's amazing.
I just want to thank you for having us again.
Oh,
this
you're
is really
coming
such
back
a treat
again.
To share this.
It is. It's
thank
very
you.
Important to share, because I think sometimes people are just uncomfortable. They think about taking a tango class, but, you know, I got two left feet. I don't have the clothes. I don't have the shoes. I mean, I want to get rid of all that so people
it's over.
Just
it's
get.
It's 2013. No more excuses, you guys.
No more excuses.
This was a plain dress? Oh, see, now it's turned. See? Plain dress turns into tango dress, so don't tell me you don't have anything to wear either.
Or left feet.
Yeah, so there, you know, there's all these things you can get. Dance shoes, there are some expensive ones, there are not expensive ones. You just come out and dance.
And you just
do it.
You just
gotta
do it. Yeah.
You gotta do it, exactly. Join us.
All right.
Join us. Happy New Year, everyone, by the way.
It is Happy New Year. All right. Well, my voice is still here, so let me close out the show. I still have a voice. So thank you. Really, everybody, get out. Tango. Tango's not for you, salsa. But just try something new. You know, get out of your old routine. It's a new year. It should be a new you. So really, you know, there's so much available to
so
you.
So much, absolutely.
And coming to my show next week, we're going to do a beauty show finally for the year. Josh Rosebrook, our friend, is coming back. You know, hair care, skin care specialist. We'll talk about what's happening in hair, talk about some of the new things that are coming into his skin care and hair care line. So it should be a very fun show. Josh is always very entertaining. Very entertaining. So tune in next week at noon. This is Alayna's Beauty Talk and More on LA Talk Live.
See you on the dance floor out there.
All right, you tell them, Alayna.
Right. Get dancing. Get moving.
Bye, everybody. All right, Brenda, did you get your...
for searching love, I found it. Ended up with my heart and soul. About time that you know. If you just believe.
Tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.